chapter 26, verse 17 to 30. Matthew chapter 26, verse 17 to 30. Pray that there's a word for you. If you have a lot of Bibles, turn them. If you have digital Bible, go to fire.
Children. You know how to know that they don't love you? Because they tell you. by the way they treat you. They may say to you, I love you, but the way they treat you is that I don't love you. And you may have a whole lot of folks like that, but I'll tell you one. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you. God loves you so much that he sent his own lamb to be slaughtered for you. So that no matter what comes about you, around you, within you, you can be free of this. God loves you. I got to say to it rings in your ear. If there was anything that you heard today that you want to take with you, whether you whisper it or hum it or sing it or say it to yourself, God loves you. Because in these challenging times, you need to be reminded that God loves you. When you're not reminded that God loves you, you get a sense that the world is against you. And if you feel like the world is against you, then you get into defensive mode and you begin to attack back at people who really ain't even attacking you. It really ain't about you. But you're fighting a battle that you feel you're called to because it seems like everybody's fighting. But the reality is nobody's fighting. Everybody's lost. Everybody's scared. Everybody's afraid. But nobody's really fighting. And it seems like they're coming right at you.
You keep
hurts more when you fall than when you fall when you're not trying to do right. When you're not necessarily trying to do right and you fall, it's just
sometimes you feel like you're in the belly of the whale. Sometimes you feel like you're in the lion's den.
So Christ says, this Bible is the new covenant. It's a new agreement. It's a revision of the contract that we have. You have a relationship with God through the temple, through the priest, through those who are called the village individual. But now, because of my blood, you can go to God all by yourself. Y'all, I know this story. That the great one who created everything out of nothing actually wants to spend time with you. That the one who called everything into existence from nothing at all desires to engage with time with you. It's almost like that person who is your greatest inspiration, your greatest, the person who you most admire, who you never imagined that you'd ever be able to meet, somehow knocks on your door and says, "Hey, Frank, how you doing? I've been waiting to meet you." And you'd be like,
then, my brothers and sisters,